It was the gold rush. The revolutionary craze for gold and riches began in early 1848 when little gold nuggets were discovered in the Sacramento Valley. This event, which took place over several years, was one of the most significant during the first half of the 19th century. Honestly though, there isn't a whole lot of people who don't know what the gold rush is or have any sort of remorse on how it started. But what a lot of people don't know is that it had a lot to do with the Mexican-American War of 1446 that lasted until 1448. But before we can get into the connection between the gold rush and the Mexican-American War, we have to know a little more about the gold rush itself. On January 24th, 1848, the California Gold Rush began when, you guessed it, James W. Marshall, a carpenter from New Jersey, discovered a gold nugget at the base of the Sierra Nevada Mountains in the American River near Coloma, California, while building a water-powered sawmill for John Sutter. I bet you didn't guess that, but if you did, then you are truly American. Soon, the news spread that James W. Marshall had found gold at the base of the Sierra Nevada Mountains. All of a sudden, the California Gold Rush became the largest mass migration in the history of America, and the Gold Rush bringing in about 300,000 people to California. From the eastern U.S., many people emigrated to California, although people from China, France, Germany, Mexico, Ireland, Chile, and Turkey were triggered by the Gold Rush and immigrated to California, and the immigrants were soon known as the 49ers because of the year 1849. In the year 1849, the Gold Rush reached its peak, but by the 1850s, miners from all over the world were coming to mine gold. With that, gold was getting much harder to find. The competition for finding gold was becoming fierce. News spread quickly. More and more people began to know that gold had been found, in large amounts too. Part of the reason why this craze was beginning to start was because of gold's value itself. In today's money, 1 ounce of gold is worth $1,285.30. So, with other immigrant settlers moving in to find themselves some of these shiny golden objects, miners created faster but more destructive ways to find gold, and the land was soon devastated. Downstream, towns were flooded with extremely large floods of mud. Hillsides were washed away with floods of water, and water supplies were poisoned with cyanide, arsenic, mercury, and other toxins. Forests of oak and pine were leveled for mining timbers as well. This discovery of gold brought up tremendous changes to the land and its people. For some, the gold rush was a disaster. Many suffered, as well as killed off by diseases, starvation, abuse, and massacre. Many others suffered from the discrimination as well. All in all, $41 million of gold had been extracted from California mines in 1850. That same year in Washington, Congress agreed to the Compromise of 1850, which admits California to the Union as a free slave state. Then by 1853, nearly 3 years later, the production of placer gold reached its peak. Every year after 1853, less gold was found, but more men were in California to share the dwindling supply. Glad to escape with their health, thousands of gold seekers returned home, while some went to San Francisco, rich or broke. Others turned to agriculture and other forms of business to survive instead of going back to their families, some even sending for their families to come live in California. Now, the gold rush soon fizzled out, and there were little and possibly no gold to be found in some areas. But before this happened, Mexico took a very large part in this escapade. When gold was first discovered, the land was technically still owned by Mexico, even though Mexico surrendered to U.S. forces. The Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo went into effect on February 2nd, but California was still under the control of the U.S. military before it officially went into effect and officially ended the Mexican-American War. The westward expansion from the east is an effect of manifest destiny, which influenced the war with Mexico. The entire idea of the Mexican-American War had to do with manifest destiny. How the war started was when the U.S. offered to buy large amounts of land owned by Mexico at the time, the biggest being California. Once the war was over, American government forces and troops had solidified their presence in history, as they owned California among other states. The reason I keep bringing up California in this is because that's where the gold rush had all started in the first place, as you should have learned. After the Mexican-American War, California became popular when gold was found on John Sutter's Island. The California Gold Rush was a large phenomenon, and because gold was found in California, the population rose. Due to this sudden rising population, California was able to become a state, and also because gold was found in California, it caused a vast economic growth. People from all over the world came to California in search of gold. Although there were many positive effects of the gold rush, many negative effects existed, such as the Mexicans and Native Americans being negatively affected by the gold rush. The California gold rush is considered to have ended when the New Mexico gold rush began in 1858. For all time, the demographic face of California was completely changed by the gold rush by becoming one of the most ethnically diverse states by the middle of the 19th century. Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's fun fact time, because who doesn't want to hear some fun facts you can tell to your friends and family? Number one, many other countries have had gold rushes, but the United States gold rush has conjured up the most gold out of anywhere else. And there you go, fun fact time's over. Oh, you say you thought there was going to be more fun facts? Well, we're going to end this video. I said fun fact. One. The Gold Rush is a relatively well-known event in American history that shaped the place we live in, California, into one of the most wealthiest states as of today. More and more people still continue to come into California, hoping to start a family of their own, just like the pioneers did so many years ago. Ah, so now you know a little bit more about the Gold Rush than before, and I hope you have learned something new today. If you didn't learn anything, that means you weren't paying attention, which isn't my problem. Well, actually, kind of is my problem, because it was my job, as well as my fellow author's teammates, to supply you with information that you'll probably forget in a few days. So here's something to remember. First, a Mexican-American War. Second, gold rush. Third, California becomes a state. Fourth, the present and the future. The future. A wild peek into the unknown. Very mysterious. Who knows? Maybe another gold rush will happen. The future is the new history. Think about that quote. Oh god, no! Wrong song, turn it off!